We're going to look now at worded problems. So once you've got all your basic skills, what you want to do is be able to read a question that has to do with fractions and then be able to use those skills to solve it. So the secret to worded problems is all in understanding what the question's actually telling you. Now, every time you read a question, there's always important information in there. Okay, so you really want to think what is important in here and underline it or highlight it. Okay, so for me, I'm looking at the question. We've got Stacey had an awesome cake made for her birthday. On her birthday, her 12 guests ate 4/5 of the cake. So she had 12 guests, 12 people at her party. Now, I think that's probably important because we need to know how many people were there. And we know that those 12 guests altogether, they ate 4/5 of the cake. With the leftover cake, she cut this into equal pieces for each guest to take home. I'd say equal pieces is important there. And this is for the leftover. She's cut that into equal pieces. Now, we want equal pieces for each guest. So how many pieces is that? That'll be 12. So we need to cut that leftover into 12 pieces. Now, the question is asking you, how much of the original cake did each guest receive? And you know, if you have different colours, it's usually a nice idea to highlight the actual question part. Because you know, in a question, there's always information, and then there's the part that's asking you what you need to find. Okay, so let's work our way through. 12 guests, they ate 4/5 of the cake. So first of all, in my head, I'm thinking about a cake, and it's divided into five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Something like that. And our guests, well, they ate 4/5 of that cake. So that's all gone. Okay, so that cake is gone. What we've got left is what's in blue. This is our leftover cake. Okay, so I'd write down, when I'm working through this, I'd write it, my leftover cake is 1 piece out of 5. That's what I have left over. Now, it says here that Stacey cut the leftover cake into equal pieces. Now, when you're looking at fractions, there's really only any problem, not just fractions, there's only four things you could really do here. Is it times? Is it divide? Is it take away? Or is it plus? Is it adding? Plus is usually obvious because it means it actually would say she adds this. So, excuse me. You can see here that she's cut this into equal pieces. And there's 12 pieces. So if you can imagine getting your knife and cutting this cake up into pieces and doing that 12 times, I can't do it very well on here, what she's doing is she's dividing that cake up. Okay, so cut makes me think, okay, I need to divide. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the leftover cake that we have, which is 1/5, and we're going to divide that cake into equal pieces, into 12 equal pieces for each guest to take home. Okay, so let's write that out down here so it's nice and clear for us. We've got 1/5, that's the leftover cake, divided into 12 pieces. Now remember with fractions, whenever you're doing dividing and timesing and you've got a whole number in there, it's a good idea to turn this into a fraction. And you can always write every whole number can be over 1. Okay, so let's work through it. Do it in red. So it's division. And remember with division, stay, change, flip. Easy. So we're going to stay the same, change the sign to a times, and then flip this over. So 1 times 1, and remember with multiplying tops and bottoms, tops together, bottoms together, oops, multiplied. So we've got 1 times 1 on the top and 5 times 12 on the bottom. So we've got 1 and 5 times 12 is 60. So what that means, as an answer, we had 1/5 of the cake left over. We cut that cake that piece of the cake into 12. We divided that 1/5 into 12, and we got 1 over 60. So how much of the original cake did each guest receive? And when you're answering a question, you want to give this as a sentence. So each guest received 1/60. Or if you wanted to, you could write this in words. So 1/60 of the original cake. So if you can imagine cutting that little cake into 60 pieces, okay, that's how much, 1/60th is how much everyone got to take home at the end. It's because they ate so much of the cake right at the start, so they only had this little 1/5th to divide up 12 ways. So 5 times 12, 60, so 1/60th of the original cake. So the key to word problems, read the question, and you want to read that question, read it a couple of times. Read it first just to get the idea, and then the second time that you read it through, highlight the key things. Is it a divide question, a plus, a multiply, a subtract? And then highlight, what do I need to do? What do I really need to give my answer at the end so that I can get it right?